So we created a user called as ERP tree. What roles we assign? Application implementation consultant and IT security manager. Okay. Very quickly, we'll go and create one more user. We'll use that name for our practice purpose. So we know very well how to create the user. You have to go to navigator under tools, how to select the task called as security console. Click on security console. So once we navigate to security console, select users. Click on add user account. And you can provide any name. So for our practice, we can use the name as Amex, American Express. Will proceed with this name to create everything. So take the same name as the username and assign the required roles. Give this name as Amex. Add roles. Basic two roles we have to assign as we discussed yesterday. Application implementation consultant. Select application implementation consultant role and select and say assign. The other role is IT security manager. Select the record and say assign. Set the password. Say save and close. So after creating the user, what we have to do? We have to run the LDAP job. We have to run the LDAP job. That's what Oracle is recommending. If you don't run the LDAP job, automatically also system can synchronize the role assignments with the user. But now these two roles are very seeded roles. To these roles, we are not assigning any business units or primary ledger. So easily system can synchronize, but when you are working on specific application, that could be GL or payables or receivables. So once you perform this similar activity, you have to run the LDAP job. Otherwise, immediately you cannot see the impact of roles for the user access. Okay. So now I'm not running LDAP, but still that those will get synchronized. Now I'll log into the instance as a Amex user. Sign out from the current user. Okay, we are able to log in. You can see the security console from this user. You can see the setup and maintenance, which will allow us to navigate to FSM. Okay, so it's not like it is not mandatory, it is a recommendation from Oracle. Okay, but these two roles, when you create a user, when you assign, it may work fine, but there are many other roles, those cannot be synchronized with the new user assignments automatically as well as immediately. It may take some time. That is the reason Oracle is strongly recommending to submit the LDAP job after assigning any role to user. Okay, this is what we have to understand. So before we proceed from here, any questions on yesterday's session or prior session? Any questions from anyone from last two sessions, please? No questions.
Hey Lakshman, I have one question.
Please.
Yeah, so when you were creating user, you didn't provide it the email address. So is it required to get a password reset link just in case if user forgets the password, like EBS?
The field is optional. Okay, that is the reason I didn't provide. Yes, if you provide the email ID, yes, you can use that email ID to reset the password. But ideally, when you create the user with employee association, password will become mandatory. This user is implementation user. So this user level, it is not mandatory. When you map this user with employee, email ID will become mandatory. Okay.
Yes, Lakshman. So once you if you have provided email address, then you can reset the password through that email address, right?
Correct.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So any other questions, please? No questions. So in today's session, we'll go through FSL. Okay, we'll understand about FSL and relevant points. So FSL stands for Functional Setup Manager. Okay, FSM stands for Functional Setup Manager. By using this Functional Setup Manager, what we can do? We'll discuss. And before we start with FSM, we have to understand the terminology what we use in the FSM. We have a different product families like financials and procurement and SCM, supply chain management, HCM, human capital management, PPM, project portfolio management, okay. CRM, customer relationship management. These are the different product families we have. SCM stands for supply chain management. HCM stands for human capital management. PPM stands for project portfolio management. CRM stands for customer relationship management. So there are a few other product families also available as a part of Fusion. Let's take these for our discussion. We have financials, where we can have a payables, receivables, general ledger, cash management, fixed assets, different applications. When I talk about procurement, as a part of procurement, you have applications like purchasing application, self-service procurement, which is equal to iProcurement application, and supplier portal and procurement contracts, the different applications we have as a part of procurement. And when I talk about SCM primarily, so inventory, order management, purchasing applications, we can treat as a supply chain management related applications. When you talk about HCM, human capital management, HR application, payroll, options, talent, there are different applications as a part of HCM. When I talk about PPM, project costing, project billing, which falls under project accounting, those two applications, as well as project management, resource management, all falls under PPM product family. And CRM, sales and marketing, other applications all falls under that CRM applications. This is how we have a different product families. So all these different product families, as per Fusion applications, when you deal with FSM, we call as offerings. These we call as offering. Financials we call as offering. The same way other product families also we call as offering. This is how we use the naming convention. Financials is one offering in the Fusion. Procurement is one offering. SCM is one offering. HCM, PPM, CRM, these all are different offering. If you take example of financials, if you call financials as offering, within the financials, we have a different applications like GL, general ledger application, AP, accounts payable application, ER, account receivable application, CM, cash management application, FA, fixed assets application. These are the different applications which we have part of financials. When you call financials as offering, what is the name Oracle given for these different applications? The applications we call as options. GL we call as option. In the same way, APR and other applications also we call as option. So this is a terminology we use as a part of FSM in the Fusion applications. Offerings means specific product families. Option means particular application in any one of the product family. Okay, this is what we have to understand. When you do the fresh implementation, when you do the fresh implementation for any client, the first task is you may create your own user or else you can use Oracle provided user. But ideally, we create our own users. That's what we tested in the last session. What is the next step? So which applications you are going to implement for your client, or you can say which offerings and which options you are going to implement for your client as per the project implementation scope. Whatever you are going to implement, those you have to enable in the fresh instance. The very first step is, after creating the user, we have to enable offerings and options. So once you enable the offerings and options, you can use those offerings and options to do the setups or to create the project. After enabling the offerings and options, what we have to do is we have to create the implementation project. Create implementation project. What is the purpose of implementation project within the Fusion instance? The Fusion instance, what are the implementation project we create, that is for the purpose of to manage the setups what we are going to do within the instance. So with the help of implementation project, what are the setups you do, you can manage all the setups. You can identify to implement financials, how many setups you have to do, how many are completed, how many are pending. So who is doing the setups for finance, which resource is doing the setup for procurement, SCM. This is how you can maintain the information and you can track all those details within the project itself. So the purpose of implementation project in the Fusion instance is just to manage the setups. It is not related to any project costing or project billing or project management. It is just related to setup management. You can manage the setup with the help of implementation project. So when you create implementation project, you have to select the offerings and options. What are the applications or offerings and options we are going to implement for the client? You have to select the offerings and options into the project. Based on that, system would create the task list. System creates task list. Say for example, we enable financial offering, and within the financial offering, we enable all these options. Now we are creating implementation project. The requirement is we are going to implement financial applications. So you select financials into our implementation project, then system would create the task list. Your task list is nothing but system will create the list of setups which you have to complete to implement the financials application. Okay, task list is nothing but list of setups which we have to complete to implement the financials applications. So when you create implementation project, you can select multiple offerings also. You select multiple offerings, say we are selecting financials and procurement into our implementation project. To implement financials and procurement, what are the setups we have to create? All the setups it will generate into our project. With the help of our project, you can access to those setups and you can do the setups. One system would create the task list to complete all these application related setups. We can assign those offering or option or task list or task to the specific team member. Simply you can say assign offering to team member. The financials you can assign to so and so team member. Which resource is going to implement financials? The financials offering you can assign to the team member with the help of project. If not entire financial, say one resource, one consultant is going to work for payables, AP, only AP, nothing but offering. A specific offering you can assign to the team member. May not be entire offering. You can assign the option also. Okay, specific option or multiple options you can assign to the team members, or else you are going to implement payables application. In the payable, to implement payable, say you have to complete 20 setups. Out of 20 setups, 10 setups you want to assign to so-and-so resource. Yes, you can assign by using the task list. Specific task list you can assign to so-and-so team member, or else only one setup you want to assign to so and so team member is possible. So whatever we are going to assign, it could be offering or option or task list or task, just for information purpose only. Just for information purpose, we can assign task or task list or offering or option to team member. Say for example, financials, I'll go and assign to Mr. X. When you look at the project, you can understand who is going to implement financials. When you look at the project against the financials, you can see Mr. X as a map, so that you can understand Mr. X is going to implement financials. That is just for information only. Mr. Y can go and do the finance setups. Even if you assign financials to Mr. X, Mr. Y can start doing the setups for financials applications. So that's how system will allow. For information purpose only, you can assign the option or offering or task list or task to specific team member. So that is the point we have to understand. Say for example, financials you assign to Mr. X. X started doing the setups. Whenever Mr. X will start doing the setups, Mr. X can update the status against the financials saying that I started working on the financials, I completed payables, I am working on the receivables. This sort of status can be updated. Once you assign the offering option to team members, give me 2 minutes, I'll complete few points. If you have any questions, I'll take. Okay, somebody unmuted. Okay, please go on mute. Once I complete few points, we can go with the questions. Fine. Once you assign the offerings or options to the team members, they can start working on the configuration. Okay, they can start with the system configuration. So based on the assignments, which resource are responsible to implement which application or which offering, they'll start doing the setups. The moment they start doing the setups, they can update the status against the project. They can update status. What status they can update? They can update the status financials offering, we started working on it, or else accounts payables setups we completed, account receivable setups are in progress, or within the accounts payables 2 setups are completed or 3 setups are completed. That's how they can update the status within the functional setup manager by using the implementation project. They can update the status. Once they update the status against the project, that can be tracked as a progress of the project. Okay, so with the help of the status, you can track. Okay, progress of the project. When you say progress of the project here, whenever you talk about project, it is related to setups. Here the project is related to setups related project. You are going to manage the setups to implement any offerings or options. Okay, what are the setups you are going to do? How many setups are completed? How many setups are pending? All these details you can specify in the instance. For that you can create the implementation project. Okay, so this is what you have to understand. Once you create implementation project with the help of functional setup manager by using the concept called as configuration packages, you can move the setups from one to other instance. Okay, by using the, please go on mute. Please, we'll go with the questions. Okay, just don't unmute when we are discussing this. So by using the concept called as configuration packages, if you complete all the setups in one instance, you can move all the setups to different instance also. So this and all we can do within the FSM. By using the FSM functional setup manager, you can enable offerings and options as per the client requirement. For which offerings and options client take in the subscription, as per the subscription you can enable the offerings and options. Against those offerings and options, you can create the implementation project to perform the setups. Whenever you create the implementation project by selecting the offerings and options, system would create the task list, and you can assign the offerings and options, or you can assign the offer only offerings, one or multiple offerings, or one or multiple options, or one or multiple task lists, or specific tasks to the team members. So based on the assignment, the users or say consultants will start working on the implementation project to perform the setups, and they can update the status, what setups are completed, what setups are not completed, and based on that you can track the progress of the project related setups. And what are the setups you perform by using the functional setup manager? If you want to move the setups from one instance to other instance, yes, you can do that. So this is what we have to understand about functional setup manager. Once we go and do in the instance, it would be more clear for us. Before we start with this enabling offerings and options, creating implementation project, assignment and setups, any questions from anyone, please? Any questions here, please?
Lakshman,
please.
Assign offering options, task list, task to team member. First also offering vachindi kada, first offer and options vachindi kada, first one.
Please don't speak in Telugu.
Okay. 58th column, already enable and offering and option has came, and again assign offering and options, task list, task to team member. Two times it will came. What is the why we have to create two times assign offering options,
assign offering and options? Here you are enabling, here you are assigning. There is a difference.
Okay,
enable means you activate. If it is activated, then okay, you can assign. Okay, you can just take okay project. Which offerings and options are enabled, those only would be available to select into project. Once that is available okay in the project, you can assign to team members.
Okay.
Any other questions, please? Background noise, please. Please take it off from your end. Okay, there should not be any background noise. If you have any question, you can unmute and you can raise your question. Any questions, please?
So Lakshman,
any questions from others? Okay, seems to no questions. Now we'll go and see all these points. Okay, in case of first instance, we have to enable the offerings and options. So how to enable the offerings and options in the first instance, how to create implementation project, how to do these assignments, we'll go through all these points now. Okay, fine. So go to instance. The very first step is, in the fresh instance, we have to enable the offerings and options. To enable the offerings and options, first click on the username. It will open the panel. Click on setup and maintenance. This setup and maintenance task will navigate us to FSM page. Click on setup and maintenance. Click on task list. Okay, we are going to enable the offerings, right? Fine. So that's one step is enough. Click on the user, click on setup and maintenance. Okay, we land in this page. To enable offerings and options, go to actions. Okay, click on actions. And here you have action called as go to offerings. Click on go to offerings. You can select it. Here you can find out the offerings. What are the offerings are available within this instance? These are the offerings available in this instance. Select our financials offering. You can click on financials offering. And here you can see what applications are part of this financials offering. You could see as a description. So here you can see the financial offering includes assets. Assets means fixed assets and ledgers. Ledgers means general ledger application, cash cycle, nothing but cash management application, invoices and payments. It's a payables application and accounts receivable directly they given the name. Collections means we have advanced collections application also, that application is also part of this. And setup of subledger accounting and tax configuration. These all are part of financials offering. Now to understand about this financial offering, what features we have and what setups we have to complete, you can go to related documents. So expand this related documents. Here you can see the financials offering related documents, associated features, setup task list and tasks, the business objects and enterprise application. These documents won't provide you the good information which we have to understand, but just they're given as a part of this documentation. You can look into those documents also if you want to check. Primarily, you can just look into these for information purpose. So the first document is associated features. The document is available in these three different formats. You can download in the PDF or HTML or Excel format. So any one of the format you can download. Let's download that associated features document by in the PDF format. Okay, just click on PDF. The same document will get downloaded in the PDF format. Okay, say okay. You can open that. So in this document you can find out what are the high level associated features we have for entire financial applications. You can see, okay, you can see the resource, users and security, and supplier invoice processing, suppliers and approvals related to suppliers, okay, and tax payables. And we have a different option, invoice routing. The different options we have, like they don't give everything very detailed level, very high level features they are providing. The associated functionality also you can use according. Okay, segment security and payments, bank accounts. Okay, related to payments, what are the other features are available, everything they are giving here. Expense application and fixed assets related, what are the different options we have, like different features we have which we treat as features related to fixed assets. Okay, customer invoice processing means receivables. They provide these features very high level. Okay, so those all you can find within this document. It's around 42 pages document. When you are practicing, you can go through it. Okay, so maybe just for information you can go through. You don't need to do anything based on this document. We will discuss the topics and how to implement, how to do the setups for specific functionality, what process need to be followed also we'll see. And if you want to look into the setup task list and task document, click on the any one of the format. So it will download the file. So wait for a second. The file size is little bit big document, so it takes time. Yep. Say okay. Open the file. Here you can notice 598 pages document. Here they provide all the setups which we are going to see as a part of financials offering once you create the project. Okay, here they clearly they specify which is mandatory, which is optional and everything. And select one of the tasks, say accounting calendar. Okay, you don't need to think about what is accounting calendar if you are not aware of it. Just for information I'm taking through. This is one of the setup which we have to complete. So when you look at this, this is task list or task. Here they are giving task list or task. This task, this manage accounting calendar is type is task and description. Okay, review and update existing groupings of accounting periods and creating the new grouping. That means by using this, you can create the accounting periods So this we can create as a part of general ledger application. Product is general ledger. It falls under product family called as financials. And when you talk about this setup is required setup. So required, they're given as a why, that means yes. It's a conditional required why. Yes, it's a conditional required. This accounting calendar related information, you can export as well as import also, that flexibility we have in instance. And CSV export import. Okay, this data you can export or import with the CSV files also. So that's how they are giving the complete information. Okay, take any task. The task is mandatory or optional, and whether the task is belongs to payables or receivables or general ledger application. The task related data can be imported or exported, or which options are available. Complete information you can see within this document. Okay, just you may go through this document if you think this is useful before you start with the instance. But just for information they given. They're not going to do anything with this document. You don't need to refer this document also for any other purpose to do the setups. Just for information, you may go through once. The business objects, enterprise applications, you don't find any useful information in those documents. If you want to verify, you can download it, you can check that. Okay. So that's how you can select specific offering and you can go through the relevant documents if you think those are useful. In the same way, we have a different product families. So you want to look into procurement related offering, then click on procurement. Talks about what we can handle with the procurement and relevant documents also you can see. Okay, so now I'm selecting the financials again. When I'm going to implement this financials, I have to enable the financials offering. But in this instance, you could see the financial offering is already enabled because this is vision instance, already Oracle enabled. But in case of fresh instance, you don't see the status as enabled. You can find the status as not enabled. If you see the status as not enabled, what you have to do is you have to click on opt-in features. Click on the tab called as opt-in features. Click on opt-in features, which will navigate us to the page from where we can enable the financials. So here already financials is enabled in this instance. By default, you could see as a disabled mode. I'm just disabling for our discussion purpose. Just 1 second. Yeah. Click on done. Okay, see, this is how you can see. If it is a fresh instance, you can find as
Lakshman.
Please.
I have one doubt here. You are selecting the unselected this offerings option. Once the setups, once you enable and these options, any module you set up, after that one user came into picture and unselect these offerings, what will happen? What is the impact?
No impact. Okay, if it is enabled, it would be available to create the project. If it is not enabled, it won't be available to select into project. But already for existing projects, there won't be any impact even if you disable.
After setups all has been completed, even though
any point of time you can disable it, no impact. But if you want to create the project, you have to enable. You enabled, you created project, you did all the setups, disable it, no issues. It will support.
Okay.
No impact.
Okay.
This is only for the purpose of selection. Once you select, even if you deselect, no use.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So in the fresh thing,
These changes are at user level, right?
These are not at user level. Okay, I'm not selecting anywhere user when I'm doing these changes. This is entire instance level.
Okay.
Yeah. What we are
we can do these at user level also, right? Like
you cannot do it. You cannot do it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So
okay,
you cannot do this at user level. This whatever the options or offerings we are going to enable, that is applicable for entire instance.
Okay.
Now, if you go and enable, if you go and log into the same instance which I'm using, you also will see the status as a not enabled only. If I go and enable, you will find the status as enabled.
Yeah, I understand.
This specific setup. This is instance specific setup. If something is user setup specific, we have to select the user and we have to do it. But here we are not selecting the user.
I got that. I understood that. So I realized that. Thank you.
Yeah. Fine. Okay. In the fresh instance, you can see the status as a not enabled. What you have to do is you have to click on opt-in features. Click on opt-in features and you can go and enable it. So we have a financials here. So if you enable the financials, you will get general ledger automatically. Okay, separately you no need to enable financial general ledger application. Without general ledger, you cannot use financials application. That is the reason they are not giving selection option for general ledger application. Okay, by default general ledger is selected within the financials. So I'm enabling financials. Okay, I'm enabling financial. That means we are going to implement financials for our client. Which applications we are going to enable within the financials, you have to enable again. So general ledger we get by default. If you enable the financials, you don't have any choice of choosing that. If you don't have financials as a part of a general ledger as a part of financials, you cannot implement financials. That is the reason they made it as default option for selection. They just automatically system would select. Now supplier invoice processing. It's nothing but payables application. If you are going to implement payables application, you have to enable this option. Financials is the offering. General ledger is one of the option, nothing but application or say module. And supplier invoice processing, the name whatever they given, that is for payables application. When you see supplier invoice processing, you have to understand that is a payables option. So if you are going to implement payables application for your client, you have to enable the payables, supplier invoice processing. Expenses. Expenses is a separate offering option. One second. Expanded. Yeah. So when you enable supplier invoice processing, automatically system is enabling all these sub options. Within the payables, yes, we need suppliers. Within the payables, we process the invoices which they're given as the payables. And the payments means we'll process the payments. And cash management and banking. In the payables application to make the payments, we need bank accounts. For that, cash management and banking also will get defaulted. There is no separate option to enable for cash management. If you are going to use payables or receivables, automatically system will enable cash management application. So that means for general ledger, you no need to select. Automatically system will select when you enable the financials. If you select payables our receivables applications, automatically system would select cash management application also. By default, system will provision to use. So we enable for supplier invoice processing. That means we enable payables application. If you are going to implement expense application, nothing but fusion expense, as per EBS, iExpense application, that you have to enable. Okay. Fresh instance, you could see as a disabled, you have to enable it. And if you are going to implement fixed assets application, yes, that also you have to enable. Enable expense. Okay, you have to enable fixed assets. If you want to implement customer invoice processing, nothing but receivables application, enable it. Within the customer invoice processing, you have a receivables, cash management, item collection, all these sub options we have, all system will enable automatically, you don't need to enable. Here collections means separate application, advanced collection application we have, if you are going to implement for your client, that also you can enable. And revenue management is separate module here in the Fusion, which we call as revenue management cloud services, okay. So that if you are going to implement for your client, you can enable. In the same way, if you are going to implement intra-company concept and budget concept, those also you can enable. And for finance related data, if you are going to analyze, okay, by using the BI intelligence, if you are going to analyze the data, you can enable the business intelligence and analytics for your specific applications. For general ledger data, payables data, expense related data, you can enable the checkboxes so that these application data would be available in the BI environment also, so that you can perform the analysis related to the data, and you may prepare some reports also based on the analysis. So this is how, whatever the offerings and options you want to implement for your client, you have to enable. On top of this, okay, on top of this entire financial or specific application, you can enable some additional features also that may be based on the country specific or business specific, but most of the features by default Oracle enables. We don't need to enable. If something is required, you can enable from the these features, additional features. So against the financials, I'm going to click on edit features. Click on edit. So here you could see the features. Say for example, for your client, you are going to implement the GRC applications. Okay, governance, risk and compliance, in that case you can enable, but already Oracle enabled. If you want to implement, you can implement. This is how just, so your client is public sector client, in that case the relevant options you can set. So this is how the certain controls they given. If something is you are not going to use, you don't need to do anything here, but if you are going to use something, if that is not available by default, from here you can select. Okay, so these are the additional features they given as per your client requirement. If you see something is required, you can enable, so that system will allow you to implement that relevant functionalities. So that's how entire financial level you can enable, or else there are certain features which you can enable at particular application level also, nothing but option. Okay, so application enable, you may select payables, you can click on edit. If something is applicable, you can enable it.
Actually, what type of be...
Sorry?
I have a...
Your voice is very low. It's not audible.
What type of... Can we hear it properly?
No, same. Same. Yeah, just go ahead with your question. We'll see if I can.
Yeah, my question is, what type of role one should have to implement this?
Okay, so what roles we assigned? The same roles. So we discussed yesterday, the application implementation consultant role is required to have access to FSM. Now we are in the FSM application with the help of application implementation consultant role.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, fine, thanks. So this is how application wise also you can set some additional features if are applicable. Ideally not required when you talk about finance. Whatever Oracle provides as a by default, those are more than enough. If something is required, you can set from here. That's how they are giving the option. So any questions here, please?
Yeah, just one question. On the payable setup, are we also going to cover OCR invoice processing when we do the transaction processing?
So what is that?
OCR, invoice OCR processing.
Image solution, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I included in the course curriculum. Okay.
Okay.
Included in the course curriculum. If anybody wants to understand what we are going to cover from which application, you can look into the course curriculum one time, so that may answer to many questions also if required. Okay, but nothing wrong if you are asking this question, but I'm just giving the general information. One time you can go through the course curriculum so that you can understand what we are going to cover from which application. Any other questions?
Lakshman, can you once again show the navigation through which you came to this screen?
Okay. So first you have to click on the username, click on setup and maintenance. Once you click on setup and maintenance, we will land in FSM page. go to task list, sorry, here go to actions, select go to offerings. Now which offering you want to enable, select that offering. I'm selecting financials, then click on opt-in features. Now what are the offerings and options you require, you can enable. You can enable financial offering, and what are the options you require, you can enable. Enable receivables also. Okay, so what are the options inside of this offering, those you can enable. And click on done so that system will update. Yeah, any questions here, please? No questions. So just we have seen how to enable the offerings and options. Now we'll see how to create the implementation project by using the same offerings and options. We have seen for finance application the same way. If you want to enable offerings and options for any area, you can select. I'm selecting procurement. The same process you can follow. Okay, it could be any offering. You have to select. Then you have to click on opt-in features. It will allow us to go into enable required options. That's how you can enable the offerings and options, and you can create implementation project against those offerings and options. Yeah.
Hey, Lakshman, what are these new features? There is also a new feature option. So,
okay. So you don't need to do anything with that. Okay, let's go through no issues. So select financials offering, just click on new features. So you can notice in the offering, in the specific offering. So what are the different new features they introduced in the based on the version? Okay. Here 20B they given. 20B means in every year, for each quarter, they introduce certain new patches. Through those patches, what are the functionalities added, they update here, that you could see. Here you can see 20A. 20A means in 2020, the year. A means first quarter, B means second quarter, okay, C means third quarter, D means fourth quarter. In the first quarter, A means first quarter, what are the new features they added, okay? Those they are giving as a list, you could see here.
Lakshman. Lakshman.
Please.
Yeah, here 20A belongs to some feature is available to see. And 20B, where is that feature?
See, if any feature is related to 20B, if anything is updated in the 20B, that they will update here.
Okay. So, if you mention 20B, that means this feature is available in second quarter, right?
Yeah, that is a proposed. That is proposed here. This is, they may do some additional announcement to that. But ideally, they don't give any that sort of information. So ideally, what are the features available in which revision that they are giving? These all features are available in revision, but this feature, they're just addressing. There is some additional update would be available in the 20B also. But as of now, whatever you see, all these are updated in this environment, 20B patch application. The set of patches applies every quarter.
Okay.
Can we test?
Sorry?
One release.
You have issue with the audio. So I cannot.
Probably I have to connect to phone.
Yeah, maybe. Fine. So that's how you could see all those. So these are the different releases, older versions. Okay. So revision 12, this is a 12 version. This is 13, the C. And in the 2019, what they applied, and 2018, these are the 2018 related patch related, what they released in 2018 B, and that means 2018, first patch, second patch, okay, third patch, only three patches they applied in 2019, one patch. This is how just you can do this.
Sure.
So from release
and one question. So I see, you know, all these new features, and there is an enabled column for all of these features. So is it possible to, like, you know, enable maybe only few of them and not enable something, some features which is available, but I do not want to enable them?
You cannot do that. The features wise, we cannot enable. The feature enabled in the sense, it's all about Oracle is providing that feature. If you don't want it, don't use it. Don't do the relevant configuration. Don't use, since you don't have the such kind of requirement. But enabling the features and disabling, that we cannot do what they are giving here. But few you can do. Very few features you can enable or disable. We have seen, right? If you go to opt-in features, you can enable offerings and options, but within the specific option, in the specific application, what are the features they have, they are not giving everything. Okay. So on top of it, the additional features, if you want to use that, they are giving. You take example of payables, click on this. The payables, we have a lot of functionality, but that complete features they are not giving here. So whatever optionally can be used, if required, those only they are giving the control. For remaining all, you have a different features in the payables. Those you cannot go and enable and disable from here. But if you select option called as payables, you'll get everything. If required, you can implement or else ignore it.
Okay.
Yeah. Fine. So that is just for information they've given you. Just you can go through it. So now we'll see how to create the implementation project. Okay, once you enable the offerings and options in the fresh instance, the instance which you are using for your practice, you no need to do this activity, but for our understanding, you can navigate and you can look into that. So when you are dealing with your client instance, it's a mandatory you have to enable the offerings and options. If you don't enable the offerings and options at the time of implementation project, you cannot see those offerings and options to select into project. Fine. Just click on done to close this. Okay, now click on done. Now to create implementation project, click on this task list. Here, whatever the icon you could see, this is something like notepad kind of icon. This you can call as a task list, because this will contains the tasks, or you can call as a task pan. Click on this task list. It is listing out few tasks. What we are going to do, we are going to create implementation project. Click on manage implementation projects and click on create. So here you can create the new implementation project. So I'm going to give the implementation project name as Amex. Okay, Amex implementation project is taking the default name. You can edit how you require. And automatically system is assigning this project to the current user, from which user you are creating the project. And it's copying the same name as a code and a description, and project status it is taking as a not started, and the start date from when you are going to start with the application related configuration. Okay, it's related to not when you are going to start with the project, it's with respect to the project related activities. It is related to setups. It's related to setups from when you are going to start with the setups, that you can specify here. And you can provide the tentative finish date also, by which date you are going to complete the setups. Okay, so that date also you can provide. So that's how you can provide the inputs for project creation. Fine. So any questions here, please? Just the naming and to whom you want to assign the project and when you are going to start, by which date the project related setups, the specific selected offering option setups would be completed. Those details you can provide here. So it is not necessary the project need to be assigned to the project manager. This can be assigned to any user. So there won't be any control with that user when you are working on the project. Ideally, the project is created by consultants only. Okay. Just this is for the purpose of setups. So ideally, consultants creates this project to manage the setups. Yeah, please.
Lakshman, I have one question. Can we create multiple projects?
Yes. We can create. Okay. The scenario, how okay. We'll discuss those. First, we'll create our project, then we'll go with those points.
Okay, thank you.
Fine.
Lakshman,
if you want to create multiple projects, what is the purpose of the behind this creation of multiple projects?
Yeah, we'll discuss on that. The same point I just now informed. We'll create this project and we'll go with those points. Yeah, we'll complete this and we'll go with that. Okay.
Just a question.
Let him continue, please. He's asking the question. Yeah, please.
Okay.
Yeah.
So once we implement this project, we will create the configuration package. We move into production, right? So production part. And after that, if we find that something that we already moved is not correct, can we create another project and then override existing setup?
No, you cannot override existing setups. Okay. So if that is the case, you may write SR to Oracle saying that to just clean up the data, whatever you loaded into targeted instance means production. Those you can clean up and you do the corrections in your tester development or other instance. And once everything is fine in that project, again, you can create the configuration package and you can load that configuration package file into production. That's how you can move the setups.
No, even the normal things if we have PO setup default matching is two-way and now we want default matching to three-way, these kind of options. We move to production. Now production is live. There are transactions created. How are you going to clean that up?
For small setups, directly you can do in the production, right?
Directly you can do in the production, like you do in the ERP.
Yes. Directly you can do it.
Okay.
You can do additional setups also, right? Anything you can do, or else you created, you have some setups and additional modules you are implementing, the incremental setups you want to move to production. In that case, yes, you can create in the test instance. Again, you can create one more project. That project you can just load into the target instance. What are the incremental setups, additional setups you did, those system will accept. But existing, if you want to correct whatever you created, no.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Fine.
Lakshman, initially when you tried to create a new project, so there was a name which was defaulted. So from where that name got defaulted, based on which setup?
There is no option to set up that. They Oracle programmed how that name need to be defaulted. By default, the name system will take as implementation project, since we are creating implementation project, and based on that code and description also will get defaulted. They programmed it. When you click on create, system will trigger that program and it will provide those default inputs. We cannot go and set anywhere what system has to default.
But there was a number 11 after the project name, right? So from
11 and all, it is defaulting already up to 10 already created. When you create the first one, it will create implementation project one. Then if you create one more, 2, 3, that's how already 10 are available with a name called as implementation project. So now we clicked on create, then it is triggered the number as 11.
So there is no setup that, right?
No setup. Okay, no setup. It's a simple task. Just when you are creating, you can give the name whatever you require. That's all. Fine. So let me complete this project creation. We'll go with the questions. Okay, this is how just we have to provide the inputs. Say we want to complete all the setups by end of this, or else by 20th. Now click on next. When you click on next, system will display all the offerings and options which are already enabled in this instance. Now you can see.
Lakshman, one question.
Yeah.
Lakshman, you have given June 20th date.
Correct.
After 20th, their settings has closed.
No. So that is just for information. Whatever we are giving the project level, that is for just information. Even after 20th also, you will be able to do the setups.
Okay.
Yeah, just for information so that you can track by which date this project need to be completed, how many days overdue. So for that sort of tracking, this information will be useful. Otherwise, you can ignore the finish date.
Okay, we can consider as a deadline date, right?
Correct. By which date you want to complete the setup? Yes, you are setting the date, the deadline.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Yeah. Fine. So these are the offerings which are already enabled in this instance. Here you can see financials. The reason financials is enabled in this instance. If you don't enable financials in this instance, you don't find the financials in this page. Now you can include, okay, this financials you can include into your project. Include, it will expand what are the different options we have inside. So already we have seen at the time of enabling the offering, if you enable the financials, automatically we get general ledger application under cash management application. That is the reason under financials we don't have those options. Okay, supplier invoice processing you can enable. It will allow us to access payables application, expense nothing but fusion expense application as per EBS high expense application. Include fixed assets, customer invoice processing nothing but receivables application. And if you want to implement a advanced collections application, you can include the collections also. And include revenue management, intracompany, budget concept, and BA intelligence to perform the analysis. You can enable those options also into this project. It's all about including. Just include so that we'll be able to get this finance related data for this analytics purpose. So this is how you can include. After including into project, you can say save under open project. So now whatever we included to implement all those options, system will create the task list. With the help of task list, you can create the setups. Okay, with the help of task list. Task list is nothing but it will create the setup list, which setups need to be performed to implement payables, receivables, okay, fixed assets, take any application which you are including. So for all those applications, what setups need to be completed, system will display. Just wait for a second, it will display. It takes time to generate all the tasks since we selected multiple. Yeah. Now project is created. This is our project, MX implementation project. This is assigned and this is start date, finish date. Okay. So this is a project basic information. So you can click on edit and you can update the status against the project. Once you start working on the project, you can set the status as a probe in progress. Once you complete all the setups, you can mark the status as a completed. Now I'm selecting the status as in progress, say save and update. Okay, the project status is in progress. Place the cursor on this, it says in progress. That means we started working on the project to do all the setups. Now we selected only financials into our project, or else at the time of implementation project, without selecting any offering also, options also, you can create the project. How to create, we'll see. I'm just closing this. So this is a page. Here you can see many implementation projects in this instance, because this is a test environment where people are practicing. The reality, when you do the implementation for your client, say your client is doing the business in US and you are going to do the implementation for only US operations. In that case, one project is enough. Okay, for one country, you can create one project and you can do all the setups. And if you are going to do the implementation for four countries, for the convenience, you can create the four projects, or else with one project also you can complete four country related implementation configuration. Okay, with one project you can do the implementation for multiple countries also. Anyway, we do the setups country specific. Project will provide the user interface to navigate to the specific tasks, but you can have a separate project for each and every country. If you have a separate project for each and every country, it will be easy for us to move the setups from one to other instance. Say you completed setups for US business operations. The same setups you want to move to other instance for the particular country, yes, since you have a separate project, you can move. If you create the single project and if you do the implementation for say three countries, if you want to move specific country data to other instance, that is not possible. So that is the reason generally what we do is for each country, we create the separate project. For each country, we create the separate project so that easily we can manage the setup data and we can move to other instance also. So any questions on this point, please?
So take example, we have a global rollout and we have around like, you know, 15, 20 operating units or legal entities. In that case also, each module or each offering will have a separate project?
No, not required. Not required. Country specific projects we have to create. Okay. We never create module specific or option specific. If you want to create, you can create. System will allow. I can create one project only for payables. Okay. I can create one project only for payables. That system will allow. But we should not do it. If you do it, yes, you can proceed with the setups. But when it comes to moving the setups to other instance, you'll have a challenge.
Okay. So country specific means one ledger will have a complete end-to-end project.
It could be one or multiple ledger, country specific for one country. You may have a one ledger or one ledgers for one country, one BU business group or multiple business groups, one legal entity or multiple legal entities, doesn't matter. For each country, create separate project. So further, if you are going to do that setups into one to other instance, easily you can do it.
Then how about the common setups? So there are common setups like, you know, creating enterprise, right? That
yes.
You covered initially. Which project that part will be? Because we cannot create that over and over again, right? That will get created only once.
Yeah. So that will, common options means you are talking about primary ledger and all these setups or something else you are referring as enterprise, etc.
No, even on the top of the primary ledger, there is enterprise, right? The topic that you covered yesterday. So
yeah.
Enterprise is always one, correct?
Yeah.
Under
what
the enterprise,
is,
you can have...
Yeah, got it. What happens is, in Fusion application, Oracle is providing default enterprise. Okay. So that you don't need to load it. In every instance, default Oracle is providing. As per your requirement, you can modify that. That's all. The name you can change. The enterprise primarily for HCM applications. As per HCM requirements, the defaults and controls you can set. That you don't need to move from one to other. That's how we have.
Okay. So each project will contain only, GL part and everything below that, right? The GL, ledger, you know.
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. Fine. So now we'll create the project without including any offering or options. Okay, just click on create. I'm giving the name as test implementation project. Okay. Just directly click on save and open project. Project is created. After creating the project also, you can include the offerings and options. So here you have a search. You can search and select offering, or else task list means specific option, payables or receivables or general ledger. Task means specific task. I want to include financials into this project. Financials, click on apply. Now system would assign the financials offering into this project. So if you create the project with only financials, later you can include any other offerings and options into the same project. That is possible. And again, after adding this financial offering into project, you may complete all the setups. Even if you delete the setups, even if you delete the project, your setups will remain as is. Okay, setups will remain as is. So this is the point you have to understand. Okay, this is how you can add the offering. Okay, even you can add the options. So we'll see those points also. Any questions here, please?
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Hi, Lakshman. So once you create the project, how do you migrate to the other instance?
I'll show you that process once we complete the setups.
Okay, good. So usually how do we implement? Is it production first and then build the non-prods later?
No. First we'll go with the non-prods, test instance and all. We'll do the setups, we'll showcase to, we'll just present to the client as a prototype sessions or say CRPs, UATs. So everything is finalized. Then what is the solution is finalized, we'll do that in the production.
Okay, good. Thank you.
Yeah. Fine. Okay. Yes, I'm closing this project. So I'm going to MX implementation project, what we created. Now just expand financials. Within this, you can find the task list. So this is our system created. The moment you select financials into project, system created separate task list. You could see here, define invoicing and payment configuration. This task list contains all the setups which are required to implement the payables application. Okay, all setups related to payables. The same way for each and every application will have a separate folder to implement fixed assets. These are the setups. So clearly you can see which is mandatory, which is optional. These setups all are mandatory. You could see with the star mark. When you are doing the setups for any application, which setups are mandatory, which is optional, you can notice. And expand receivables folder. Okay. Again, you can expand subfolder inside of receivables. You can see which are mandatory, which are optional. Okay. So we created a project. Now, if you want to assign these financials to specific resource, you can select financials and you can click on assign tasks. You want to assign this financials configuration responsibility to which team member, that you can select. You want to assign to resource called as ERP3. Search, select, say apply. The same financials you want to assign to multiple resource, in that case you can add it. And you can set the due date. What is your time to finish this finance setups? The finance setups need to be completed by 8th. Say 1 close. This is how you can assign the entire offering to specific team member. Now you can expand financials, and for within the financials for every task, okay, is all we call as tasks. Whatever you see with the folder option, okay, folder icon, those we call as a task list. The task list may refer the entire application or list of the tasks. These all we call as tasks. Now you can see these all tasks are associated with the ERP tree, because entire financials we assigned within that financials, what are the tasks we have all need to be completed by this resource. Or else specific option you want to assign to different resource. Now you can select, say, payables you want to assign to different resource. Select payables. Define invoicing and payment configuration means payables. You select it. Click on assign tasks. You want to assign to who? Okay, you want to assign to so and so user. I'm selecting one user. Click on apply. So click on done. So assigned, I can give the due date to complete the payable setups. Payable setups should be completed by tomorrow. So save and close. Say, for example, payable setups are completed by the resource. Since payable setups are completed, you can set the status as a completed. Here you could see the status as not started. Or else the resource started working on the payable setups, click on the same status. Okay, you can click on the same status. Or else select this payables, define invoicing under payment configuration, click on edit status. You can click on edit status tab or click on the status icon and you can set the status in progress. So the consultant started doing the setups for payables that you can set it up. And say payable setups are completed, or else say fixed asset setups are completed. In that case, you can update the status as a completed. And say completed. Just say one close. Since we selected fixed asset setups are completed, if you expand the fixed assets, you can see all task status as a completed. Even if you set the status as completed, still system will allow you to do the setups. Even if you don't set the status as not started in progress, system will allow us to do the setups. Okay, this status for just for information purpose only. For example, we'll see how where this status will impact. Click on done. Now the project is assigned to the current user only, right? Click on overview. Now see the status is updated here. So in MX implementation project, total tasks are 1036. The project status is in progress. Within that, 22% setups are in progress. You can click on that, it will display which tasks those are. You can click on the 22%. So which setups all those the system is displaying. Okay, here you can see 4% tasks are completed. How many setups? 46 setups. Here in progress 226 in the pop-up you can see. 22% out of entire project tasks. The status is in progress. The number of tasks are 226 and 4% setups are completed. Those are 46 tasks setups and 764 setups not yet started. Okay, assignment status here you can see this week how many need to be completed, next week how many need to be completed. Here we given the due date for one resource, accordingly it is displayed. And go to assignment status by task list. So here you can see the option wise. These are the different options. Fixed assets configuration, you can see that is a completed 46 tasks. So payables in progress, remaining all not yet started. If you click on this fixed assets, which setups are completed, it will display. You can click on this bars, it will display those task names also. Go to resource status. You could see who is going to work on which area and what setups in this week, how many need to be completed. All you can see. The ERP tree user. So in the next week, 877 tasks are assigned to complete for ERP tree user. Okay, for this user. In this week, 113 setups need to be completed. So here you can verify this week how many setups need to be completed. Next week, who has to complete which setups? That's how you could see. Okay. So this is how you'll be able to track how many setups, which resource, what is the progress. For that reason, this project is very much useful. So to do the setups in the Fusion instance, project is not mandatory. But if you create the project, you can move the setups from one to other instance. If you don't create the project, you cannot move the setups. So that is the reason ideally we create the implementation project to do the setups. Open the project. Okay. So if you want to assign specific tasks to so-and-so resource also, you can do it. For example, this task need to be completed for a different resource. Already this is assigned to ERP tree. You can select this task, click on assign tasks, This task is already assigned to this resource. I am removing this specific task for ERP tree. Only this task I want to assign to other resource. Search with ERB. Say apply. So this is how you can assign. So what is a permitted and other roles we'll discuss. Those are separate points. You can set the due date also. This is how you can set. Okay. We can assign that specific entire offering or option or task list task to specific team members. You can update the status that you can track at entire project level as a progress. So these are the points we have to understand. And there are different options like help, go to task, selected scope, status, and all these options also. We will discuss in the next session. Okay. So far, whatever we discussed, any questions from anyone, please?
On the last column, there is a view reports, right? What is that?
That's what I'm telling. We'll discuss all those. Okay. So see, if you take example of fixed assets, it will show the report in the fixed assets, how many setups are completed. Okay. How many setups completed, that relevant report it will provide related to progress of the fixed assets. I'll take all these options. See, you have a different column. Help, go to task, selected scope, status, and all this. Due dates, notes, authorized roles, view report. All we will discuss. Okay.
Also, one more question. Like, you know, I mean, we can see here, these tasks are like independent, right? I can go to task number, like, you know, any task I can pick up and I can complete that task, right?
Correct.
Do we set up a dependency or something, or is there any dependency already set up?
Yeah, if any dependency is there, system will display the dependency also. Okay, here, expand payables. See, these all set tasks as a dependency. Okay.
So tasks
in the sense that is dependency. It talks about if you want to complete so and so setup, a so and so setup, what is the dependency task? You click on that, it shows what is the dependency. So define payables. Okay. So if you want to do this,
all the dependency. Tax,
yeah, sorry, please.
Yeah, so all these dependencies Oracle defined, right?
Oracle defined.
You cannot change it.
You cannot set it up. How the product is designed and developed and how that relevant functionality will work, accordingly, they just did the mapping of dependency. We cannot set it up anything. Okay. Just we have to follow.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, Lakshman. Just Sajan here. Just want to hear. You have assigned tasks to a particular user.
Correct.
And if suppose due to some reason that user is not able to do the task, and in that same team there is another user who will be doing the task, do you have to make a configuration change on the setup here to assign to the task, or can that user just log in using his username and start working on that task?
The assignments as well as the statuses what we are setting, you can take an example of assignment. The assignment doesn't have any control. Even if you take the status also doesn't have any control. You can assign this task or task list or offering or options to one resource. Any other resource can go and do the setup. You don't need to change assignments. That is just for
this session. Okay. This is only for then reporting purpose only, that assigned to task. Okay.
When you go to overview, project overview, we have seen, right? How many tasks assigned to whom? Which area? For that information, you can use. System is not going to have any control based on that assignment.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, thank you. Any other questions on this, please? Okay.
Just one question. Now we created this project using the role, right? Implementation consultant role. So anyone who has that role can see all the projects?
Yes, that is administrator role. Like when you have access to that, you will get access to FSM. When you get access to FSM, within the FSM, what are the projects you have, you can see. But ideally, these roles we assign to the consultants at the time of implementation. The business users will give application specific roles so that they never see these FSM related area to perform any setups or to access any projects. Consultants, for all the consultants, ideally we assign this application implementation consultant so that they can see any project. But we know very well, so the consultants will work for the projects where they are responsible. Even they have access, simply they don't go and do the setups since that is available. Right? So that's how it works.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, I mean, but they can see all the projects, basically.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, they can see all the projects.
Lakshman?
Yeah.
Looks like the setups are easier than in the traditional EBS, rather than, you know, easier here, right?
Yeah.
Because the system itself is telling what setups to do.
Correct. But is here our EBS or anywhere? It's a very important. We should know what setups we have to do. Okay, as a mandate and optional. Yes, system will give the information, but the very primary thing is we should aware of which setups need to be. But here you can find something like when you see the task, you can see that is a mandatory or optional. But in EBS case, you don't see by looking at function whether that is mandatory or optional.
Yeah, this is a little bit guided.
Yeah, correct. Guided. That's true. It's guided, very much guided. Correct. And again, all the setups you can do in one place. AP, ER, GL, FA, take any application. Okay, all you can do in the same place. But in EBS, we have to switch across the responsibilities based on which setup, which application.
Those offerings have been chosen before starting this project. Then only you would be able to set up.
Correct.
For example, you choose only I mean, there is only GL and FA and not AP. Then the system is not going to give you the AP setups.
Exactly.
In that particular project, right?
Correct. You don't include payables when you are creating the project. You cannot see payable setups in the project.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Later you can go and add it. For example, you are not adding define invoicing and payment configuration at the time of project creation. Later you can add this to project. How to add? Click on add. Here select task list. So define
invoicing.
Define invoicing and payments configuration. So you can add payables to project later.
Oh, okay. And profile options also come under setups, under the task list.
The profile.
Options.
Yeah, profile options. Ideally, you can access from the global page. It's not specific to project. Those are common, right? When you talk about profile option. Those are the common you can use for any project or any steps.
So the responsibility level profile options will also be done through global.
No, any profile option you need to include that profile options into project. There is a separate page where you can go to the profile option page. There you can set it up.
Okay.
But if you want to do from the project, so that is possible. Generally, we don't go with that. Certain profile options, certain values may not be available. Here you can search for profile options. They'll give the task, relevant task they will provide. With the help of that task, you will be able to do the relevant setups. Okay, these are the different cash management related profile options and different application profile options. Okay.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. But these are commonly used. So you can navigate from other pages or if required, same. Any other questions, please?
Yeah, Lakshman.
Yeah.
Yeah, usually how many months it will take to complete the setup for the financial project? So for all the setup. So it's a sample or medium or complex project, whatever it may
be. See, the finalization of solution takes time. If everything is finalized, you may complete all the just setups. You can complete within 1 day also. Okay, again, loading the data and all, it may take some time, conversion. So doing the setups, even less than 1 day also, we can complete the setups, whatever required for financials. Okay, that's how we can do. Any questions, please? If no questions, we can wind up. We'll connect tomorrow.
Just one follow-up question. So if solution is... Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, but noise we are getting. Can you fix that? Possible.
Yeah, I'm hearing my echo. I don't know.
If you can two devices, sometimes it happens. Okay. If
you keep... No, I think it's good now.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. Yeah, so my question is, we say Fusion is very restrictive application, right? It doesn't allow you to do a lot of customization, changes to the standard flow and everything.
It will allow to do the customizations if it is a PaaS. In case of SaaS, you cannot do the functionality customization.
Yeah, but most of the cases, 99% people are using SaaS, right? So SaaS is very restrictive, right? Just
yes.
Yeah. So in that case, I mean, there is no solution to discuss, right? Whatever Oracle is offering, we just have to accept the same process, right? Set up the master data and then complete the, you know, setup as per the requirement, right?
Yeah, correct. But we never do that much straightforward. We take the requirement, we analyze, we sit with the business users, we understand what functionality, how they are using, how they are expecting, these points and all will take. Then when you do the mapping, something is not mapped, whatever the requirement they have that is not available, we'll talk them that we treat as a gap and all. That standard process we follow, only the point is additional functionality we cannot build. In that case, we may look for some workaround, how that can be managed, if possible.
Yes, I mean, usual project, right? You know, when we do requirement gathering, we do fit gap analysis and anything there is a gap, then we come up with the RISE-W, right? And that is the part takes a longer time to implement because yes, then we are implementing, adding the RISE-Ws and extensions and complex extensions. Like when I'm talking about workflow changes and all those things, forms and all the things.
Yes.
But if it is not there, then it would be relatively very simple, straightforward implementation if you're going with this.
Kind of vanilla implementation.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. Right. Okay. Any other questions, please? Okay. Fine. No questions. Then that's all for today. We'll connect tomorrow same time and we'll continue from here. Thank you all. Have a good day and good night.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.